I'm Shubha from UT Austin, and this is work done jointly with collaborators. Today I'm going to be speaking about how we can generate captions for objects that do not have paired image caption training data. Let's look at the state of visual recognition. Current visual recognition data sets have millions of images and several thousand categories of objects. And object recognition models can identify hundreds of categories of objects. On the other hand, if you look at visual description, image captioning models generate relevant and useful descriptions about images or objects in images, and but they do so only for far fewer number of categories, specifically only for those that are present in existing image caption data sets, like MSCOCO dataset. Hence, given an image like this, which contains an object that's not in MSCOCO, existing visual captioners would generate a description to say a horse is standing in the dirt. But we know that this animal exists in ImageNet and can be classified as an okapi by all current visual CNN models. So the question that we asked is, can we generate descriptions of such objects in context without paired image caption training data? For example, to say a sentence like an okapi standing in the middle of a field. In this work, we present Novel Object Captioner, which can compose descriptions of hundreds of categories of objects in context without paired image caption training data. So I'll first present some of the insights of our model. In order to generate descriptions for several objects, we first need to recognize and describe these objects outside of image caption data sets. To do this, we train our model on external sources of data. We train our visual recognition network on unpaired image data, which is just images with labels, as seen in ImageNet. And we train our language model on unannotated text data, which is plain sentences, for example, from Wikipedia. The next thing is that we want to be able to describe unseen objects that are similar to objects that have been seen before in existing image caption data sets. And for this, as seen in some of the previous papers, we use semantic word embeddings. So we use dense word embeddings that can capture semantic similarity of words. And more importantly, we use these embeddings and incorporate them both in the input and the output of our language model. The intuition here is that our image caption dataset contains captions about some categories of objects. And we want to enable our language model to be able to generate sentences of different objects that are similar to what it is seen in the caption dataset. And we use the semantic embeddings help in this case. And then we can combine our visual recognition network and our language model to form a caption model. One thing to note here is this model does not seem very different from existing image captioning models, which are also pre-trained on ImageNet images. But existing image caption models do not generate captions of ImageNet objects. And one of the key things that we think is a problem is that these models are prone to forgetting, in the sense that although they've been pre-trained on ImageNet dataset, and once it's tuned on the image caption dataset, they tend to forget what they've seen before. This has also been observed by others, specifically the Kirkpatrick et al. Work in PNAS 2017. So they call this catastrophic forgetting in neural networks. And we want to be able to address and overcome this problem of forgetting, since pre-training alone is not sufficient. To do this, we combine all of these three networks and train our model jointly on multiple data sources. Specifically, we train our visual recognition network on unpaired image data, the image caption network on pairs of images and sentences, and a language model on plain sentences. All of these three networks share parameters and are trained jointly with different objectives. And the aim here is that we do not want our model to forget what it has seen when it's been trained on ImageNet. Going into some of the details, our visual recognition network uses the VGG16 network with a multi-label loss, and it's trained on unpaired image data, which is images, and it's trained to predict multiple labels. Specifically, it predicts confidences over the entire vocabulary of words. For a language model, we use a single LSTM layer, which is trained to predict the next word given the previous words. and it uses, we use glove embeddings as the semantic embeddings, both in the input and the output. And this is trained on unannotated text data from Wikipedia, GigaWord, and other text corpora. Our caption network combines the output of the visual recognition network and the language model, simply using an element-wise sum. And it's trained on the image caption data. More specifically, we look at captions from the CoCo data set, and we also extract multiple labels from these captions for the images to train our visual recognition network. And then the entire caption network is trained to predict the caption corresponding to the given image. And all of these three networks are combined and trained jointly with shared parameters. What I mean by this is more specifically is that in each batch of inputs during training, we have some images with labels, some a different set of images and captions, and some just plain sentences. And all of these three networks are trained simultaneously with these shared parameters. In our paper, we report multiple experiments to evaluate our model. Here, I will focus on three main things. First is the in-domain setting, where we hold out some objects from the CoCo dataset. I'll also report results on a couple of important ablations. And I'll also report results on human evaluations on ImageNet dataset. So for empirical evaluation, in the in-domain setting, we look at the MSCOCO dataset, which contains pairs of images and captions. We can look at just the captions as sentences to train our language model. And we can also extract labels from these to get images with multiple labels to train our visual recognition network. To evaluate the model, we create a held-out dataset by holding out certain concepts or certain objects. Specifically, we hold out image caption pairs pertaining to certain objects from the CoCo dataset. And this is used for evaluating our model. And the model is trained on the remaining data. The metrics that we use for evaluation are the F1 score, which measures the model's ability to recognize and incorporate new words. More specifically, we're just seeing if the word is mentioned in the description or not. And we also use Meteor to measure fluency and sentence quality. We compare our model with two prior works. First is the LRCN work from CVPR 2015. But note that this does not caption novel objects. The other is the model DCC from last year's CVPR. This model essentially copies parameters from the novel objects from a similar object that has been seen during training. But this is not end-to-end. So if you look at the F1 scores, we can notice that our model significantly outperforms previous work. And one thing to note is that the LRCN model is unable to recognize these novel objects that it's not seen in paired image caption training data. When we look at Meteor scores, all models have reasonably good Meteor scores because they still generate relevant descriptions about these objects in image, about the image itself. But our model outperforms previous work on novel object captioning. So let's look at which are the important aspects of our model that really help give us this performance boost. So I'm going to look at a few ablations, and these are going to be evaluated on held-out CoCo objects. So the first thing is when we just use the semantic embedding in our language model, our captioning model is still is able to recognize and generate descriptions for held-out object categories, as seen by the reasonably good F1 and Meteor scores. And another interesting thing that we noted was when we froze the CNN, which was trained on the image and images and labels, we noticed that the F1 score improved considerably. This again relates to the forgetting problem that I mentioned before, the sense of once it's tuned, it tends to forget what it's seen before. But when we freeze it, it's able to recognize these objects. And jointly training all of these networks together on the different data sources gives us the best performance. We also evaluate a model on ImageNet. Specifically, we select 638 object classes that are not mentioned in CoCo. And we note that our model is able to describe several of these object categories and a lot more compared to prior work. But we evaluate, we ask human mechanical Turk workers to evaluate our model. So the first category that we evaluate is with respect to word incorporation. Specifically, we ask the question, which model incorporates the word or the name of the object in the sentence description better? And the next is with regard to image description, which is which sentence or model describes the image better? And we can see that from these graphs that human raters preferred our model over previous work. Here are several examples from different categories of objects that our model is able to caption. Let me focus your attention on the example of a jackal. So here it says a small brown and white jackal is standing in a field. So in all of these examples, our model is able to generate captions about these objects in context. And here are some more examples of descriptions from different categories. Let me bring your attention to the model of, to the figure on the bottom right, which is a woman is posing for a picture with a chiffon dress. Here it uses the word chiffon as an adjective in this description. Our model also makes several different categories of errors. You can see a lot more in the paper. One common error is just repetition, which is that it tends to repeat words, okay, or object names in the sentence multiple times, as in the balaclava example. Here's another example of a gymnast, where it says, a man gymnast in a blue shirt doing a trick on a skateboard. So here it gets the gender wrong, and it also tends to hallucinate objects that is not present in the images, possibly seen in image caption datasets. So the key takeaway from this work is that when we use both semantic embeddings and train a model jointly on multiple different data sources, we're able to caption hundreds of categories of objects, and we're able to caption them in context. Thanks, and please come by our poster, which is poster 11, later today. There's also other work, this CVPR, that looks at the same task. There's some work by Microsoft Research Asia as well in the poster session. So